In the previous weeks, we went through all steps of the new step strategy. This week, we will focus on how these steps can be combined in an integrated design for a zero-energy building. I will go through all the steps of the approach to compare the solutions that are applied in the three case studies. Starting with the research step. In this step, we focused on the current energy demands and the local climate conditions. Since all case studies are located in the Netherlands, they deal with the same climatic circumstances. The most important design guidelines from the climate analysis are as follows. By the average temperature of 10 degrees throughout the year, we want to maximize the solar gains and at the same time minimize the energy losses through the building envelope to preserve the gained heat. During the summer, it's important to prevent overheating, especially in non-residential functions with high internal loads. The in the previous step formulated guideline formed the base for the next step, reduce. We first focus on passive reduction. In a temperate climate, a lot of energy is used for heating. By maximizing the solar gains during the winter, large savings can be achieved. This principle is also applied in our case studies, where large glazed facades are found on the south orientation, as for example in Projecto Roble, where a large glazed south facade results in high solar gains. Now we gained the solar heat, we want to preserve it. This is done with high-performance thermal insulation around the entire building envelope. Pret a Loger needed to be post-insulated, since in the original building no insulation was present. Together with the greenhouse that functions as a buffer between the outside and the inside, the transmission losses were largely reduced. The high insulation values of the building cause a new problem during warmer days, overheating. Especially in buildings with a high internal load like Pulse and Projecto Roble. In these case studies, multiple passive measures were taken to reduce the cooling demands. As a first step, the layout of the building was optimized. The offices were placed on the Corde Nord facade, while spaces with a smaller internal load were placed on the warm south side. At the same time, solar shading, in this project by Green Plants, was placed on the south facade to reduce the solar gains during the summer. In addition to these measures, summer night cooling is used. The heat that is accumulated in the building during the day is removed from the building by the fresh outdoor air during the night. In the Pulse building, the lecture halls have a high internal load by the large amount of present students with their laptops. Therefore, these rooms are placed on the cooler north facade. Beside that, the solar shading system blocks the sun and at the south facade during the summer. The other passive reduction measures that were applied in the case studies focus on the use of another characteristic of the sun, daylight. Like north-facing windows, in shed-shaped roofs, a pond to reflect daylight deeper into the offices, and solar tubes. On the roof of Pret a Loger, we find the solar tube. The inside of the tube reflects the sunlight and brings it deeper into the building, providing additional daylight to the living room. So these were the measures used to passively reduce the energy demands. Now we proceed with the active measures. Actively, we reduce energy by more efficient use of the energy-using equipment. LED light is an effective way to reduce the electricity use. By replacing the light bulbs with LED, large savings are achieved. 10 to 50% when replacing fluorescent lighting by LED light, and 75% for the replacement of conventional light bulbs in houses. Another way is to optimize the time ventilation, heating, cooling and lighting needs to be activated. This can be done by placing sensors that continuously measure presence of people, air quality, light intensity and temperature. With this sensor, the energy demands for heating, lighting and ventilation can be reduced with 10 to 30%. Now the energy demands of the case studies are reduced, both passively and actively, it's time to continue with the second step of the approach, reuse. Heat recovery from ventilation exhaust air to preheat incoming air is the most common way energy is reused in buildings. Also, our case studies, this type of heat recovery is applied. In Pret-à-Loger, heat is also recovered from the shower water. The remaining demands are generated by heat pumps. Heat pumps are very common in zero-energy building concepts. The source of heat pumps varies, and so it does for the different case studies. Pulse uses a ground source heat pump combined with thermal energy storage. An air source heat pump is applied in Projecto Roble, which uses the outdoor air as a heat source. And finally, Pret-à-Loger, an air source heat pump, which makes use of the heat from the greenhouse, is used. By completing the reuse step, we have arrived at the final step of the approach, produce. Since our case studies make use of a heat pump for heating, their demand for electricity is high. In all case studies, this electricity is provided by PV panels on the building roofs. In a pulse building, the electricity produced by the PV panels is used in a very efficient way. PV systems generate electricity with a direct current. However, our electricity grid works with the alternating current, and therefore conversion needs to take place. This while LED, USB ports and other sustainable electricity systems again worked with direct current, resulting in an additional conversion. In the pulse building, a more intelligent system is used. The direct current generated by the PV panels is directly used by the USB ports and LED lighting. Thus, two conversion steps can be avoided for a part of the generated electricity, resulting in less energy losses. In Projecto Roble, the heat pump only functions as a backup system, since the main heat source for this building is biomass. A wood stove with a heat exchanger provides the generated heat to the connected floor heating during colder days. By completing the last step of the approach, zero energy buildings were created. But how can we present all these measures into one integrated scheme? To wrap up this lecture, I now show you how this is done for two of the case studies. Here you see the scheme for Projecto Roble. Now we expect you to draw a scheme like this for the final assignment, which presents all measures you want to implement in your building. It is also possible to make a sketch, like Andy did here, for the Pret-à-Loger building.